Lone Star Conference fans, we are All Access this week, Tarleton week, right here on LoneStarConference.org. Of course, I'm joined by Commissioner Stan Wagnon. Before we get into Tarleton week, let's kind of take a look back at the fall championship. It's been an exciting time for the Lone Star Conference, and let's start with cross country hosted in San Angelo.
Yeah, we've had a great fall, Travis, and as you mentioned, it all started with our cross-country meet in San Angelo. They did a wonderful job of hosting that event, and cross-country championship is always one of our bigger events. We've got 11 member schools, 10 of them sponsor cross-country programs, and so there was a lot of participants. This year we had a great turnout of family and friends and fans that came out to watch the races. As far as the results go, Midwestern States women claimed the title for the fourth year in a row. And on the men's side, Eastern New Mexico won the championship for the first time in school history. So I thought that was a great balance of kind of a historical power that won a fourth straight title, and then an up-and-coming program who won for the first time in school history. And so really was good to see those results from our conference meet. And then it carried forward to the regional championship. The following, or actually 2 weeks later, Midwestern was fortunate enough to host the NCAA regional in Wichita Falls. MSU's women won that championship for the first time in school history, and Eastern New Mexico's men claimed the regional championship. And so it's the first time in a number of years that we've had the men's and women's regional titles coming home to the Lone Star Conference. So it really was a great performance by the LSC student athletes.
Outstanding fall for cross country. Moving on now to soccer, another up-and-coming program hosted the Lone Star Conference tournament in Abilene Christian University.
That's right. Abilene Christian has had a wonderful fall in women's soccer. They capped a regular season championship, and that's what gave them the right to host the conference tournament. And then once we were there, number two seed Midwestern State kind of turned tables on Abilene Christian. You know, last year Midwestern won the regular season, Abilene Christian knocked them off in the tournament. This year Abilene Christian wins the regular season, Midwestern returns the favor by winning the tournament championship, winning the Lone Star Conference championship at the tournament. And so both of them advanced into the postseason, and Abilene Christian was fortunate enough to advance and win the regional championship. Their run ended in the national quarterfinals, but you know, as you can see, we've talked about three sports so far, and LSC has claimed a regional championship in all three of those, so we've had a great fall to this point.
Tremendous representation thus far. And then moving on to volleyball, a dominating force, West Texas A&M again hosting volleyball.
Yeah, West Texas A&M is obviously in volleyball one of the better traditions we have in the conference. They've done a great job of sustaining their level of success in that program. This year was no exception. They did have a lengthy conference winning streak that came to an end. Tarleton, since it's Tarleton week, Tarleton was the first team in the conference to knock off West Texas in volleyball in, I think, 5 or 6 years. And so that was an important moment for LSC volleyball this fall. But WT rebounded from that. They went on to win the regular season title, and then they defended their home court in the tournament to win, I think, the sixth consecutive conference championship there for WT. They went on to the regional championship, and this year was really a strong year for LSC volleyball. You know, we had more than just a one-horse race. Angelo State had a great year. Abilene Christian had a great year. Both of them were rewarded with NCAA bids, and so they went out and represented the conference well. We didn't walk away with the regional championship this year in volleyball, but I think our team served notice that we're here to compete for the long haul, and so I'm looking forward to big things from our volleyball programs next fall.
Absolutely. And then when you talk football, got off to a great start at Cowboys Stadium, Lone Star Football Festival, and kind of quietly, Midwestern State just ran through the regular season.
Yeah, you know, Midwestern State was unbeaten in the regular season for the first time in school history, and I know Abilene Christian went undefeated in the regular season last year, but I can guarantee you it's not easy to go through the Lone Star Conference regular season unbeaten, and so really was a great feat for Coach Maskell and the Mustangs to go through that, become the champions of the conference, and then to represent us in the playoffs. Abilene Christian also earned an NCAA playoff bid, and then West Texas A&M has been selected to represent the conference in the Kansas Bowl. And so you've got those three programs in the postseason for the Lone Star Conference, and then we'll see how the regional tournament comes out, as you know, obviously the football playoffs are underway. When you look at our fall as a whole, it's been so successful. You know, one sport we haven't talked about is men's soccer. And in men's soccer, we won another regional championship. There's only two teams from this region that make the playoffs, and this year it was Incarnate Word and Midwestern State. Incarnate Word won the regional championship over Midwestern. They got knocked out by a very strong Fort Lewis club the week after. But the fact that those two were there, Incarnate Word won a regional championship. And then the thing that we haven't talked about is Eastern New Mexico's men's soccer team actually won the conference championship. So they were not in the NCAA field due to the selection criteria and that type of deal, but they did win the men's conference championship, and that's the first time they've done that in school history. And so really, I think we've only got four men's soccer teams, but all four of them are first-class programs and can hold their own with anyone in Division II. And so it really has been a strong fall for us.
Absolutely. Been an exciting fall. Fans, stay tuned all week and follow Tarleton right here on LoneStarConference.org. That'll do it for us. This has been another Lone Star Conference All Access.